doing sound also?
Yeah.
I have not yet ever done a nighttime run back here.
No?
I got some flashlights.
I thought about it, but I'm like, I'd be a damn bad guy.
I got a night vision camera too.
Well, I got my headlights on right now. Sticking to the trails that are not overgrown, because I haven't wanted anybody being dragged through ranches and stuff.
Yeah.
So I got a nice loop trail that goes out around that way that leads up to where we're going to go up this way. But I didn't get to go out there and chop it back. It's
yeah.
Like 80% maintained, but it's growing so incredibly fast.
Oh, I know. Everything's so thick right now.
And then there's also a trail from the garden over to where we're going to go, where the hog trap is, and that is also growing at that same rate. That's unbelievable. Like I go through kind of, it's already replaced by the time I have gone through. And smooth and had a nice green carpet of grass and dollar weed, whatever, but it was gorgeous. And the pigs moved in about 2 months ago and now they just rooted the crap out of it.
Yeah, they do some damage.
So I've got one on the trail cam right in this zone, and then Ruth and I, within the last 2 weeks, were driving in this and we came right up on one and I could have smacked him in the butt. We were that close, he didn't even hear us.
Wow.
His head was in the weed, and then he heard us and spooked out, but we're definitely here. This is a pig trap that I built years ago, and right over your shoulder here to the, this way, is a trail that goes over to the garden that I won't drag you through because it's too overgrown. That's over your, ate them? Yeah, it's delicious. And they all disappeared, and they hadn't been back until now. So I would say it's definitely drought-related.
Yeah, I bet.
So this is our east property line, a fence line that we're following up here. And our neighbor over here is a giant lime rock mine.
Wow, that's interesting.
Which is easily visible, like on Fox 13 radar. You can see it. It's turquoise blue. It's huge.
You can find megalodon shark teeth in those.
What?
You can find megalodon shark teeth in those mines.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, we got a guy out at the Blue Pear restaurant that dives for them. And he brought in one. It was a full 5-inch, perfect condition one that he found in the Peace River.
Wow.
Diving. So this is our east property line that we're following up. from machineryauction.com.
That's cool.
So, directly, I think I might have pulled too far. You see the orange up in the tree?
Yeah.
That's a corner marker for our property line.
Oh, okay.
And then
you guys have a lot of property.
It's 27 acres approximately. So if you look straight down this line, just above the scrub greenery below, you'll see dark green behind, and there's a distinct section that's brighter. See it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that is our corner property marker for our north corner on Highway 301.
Wow.
Thank you. Thank you.